Good day. I am Allana Therese El Nibungco, and I'm with my thesis partner, Sophia Angelika Prila, and we are going to present to you our thesis proposal. Our thesis proposal is entitled as A Queuing System for SM Sucat Supermarket to Cope Up with the New Normal. As an overview, the study will assess the current queuing system of SM Sucat Supermarket in the new normal to determine the major contributors in long queues and longer waiting time of customers that cause a higher risk of acquiring the coronavirus disease 2019 or the COVID-19 due to prolonged exposure to the public. Let me start the presentation with the introduction to explain the background or basis of the problem. Today, we are suffering from an unexpected disease spreading quickly worldwide. It is known as the coronavirus disease 2019 or commonly known as COVID-19. It was first reported in Wuhan, China at the end of 2019, as stated in an article by Yu et al. And the spread accelerated to different countries progressively. According to the World Health Organization, it is a highly transmittable disease which can occur through close contact because of respiratory droplets caused by coughing or sneezing of an infected person. Based on research by Gavi Alliance, far bigger numbers of individuals were becoming infected because of the relative ease with which the virus could spread. According to Donato and Gustafsson's study, the pandemic forced many businesses to close to control the spread of the virus, leading to disrupted commerce in almost all industry sectors, including manufacturing, transportation, energy, retail, and etc. This resulted to countries having to implement different safety protocols and safety measures to reduce the probability risk of people getting infected. Now, retailing is one of the industries that is mostly affected by coronavirus in a statistic study by Stephanie et al. Supermarkets, considered as retail stores, experienced a negative shock when a shift in customer shopping behavior and consumption happened, based on the research of Jung et al. In the Philippines, almost all businesses were forced to close temporarily, except for those providing necessities, such as hospitals, banks, power companies, supermarkets, and etc., as per the IATF guidelines. According to France, supermarkets are one of the first to adopt the new normal safety protocols, such as social distancing, posting floor signages, requiring face masks and face shields, checking body temperatures, hand and foot sanitation, facility disinfection, and a limited number of customers allowed to go inside. These added safety protocols resulted in an unusual amount of long queues and longer waiting time of customers that caused a higher risk of acquiring the virus due to prolonged exposure to the public. This queuing problem becomes one of the major challenges of supermarkets in this COVID-19 pandemic. Now we go to the issue. The long queues and longer waiting times in the system expose both the customers and employees to a higher risk of acquiring the virus due to a prolonged exposure with each other. Now, the gap is, despite the availability of different studies related to queuing systems and modeling, there is a significant need for a further study because there are only a few, but not academic research, that were conducted to assess the current queuing problems in supermarkets in the new normal. The objective of the study is to come up with solutions to address the queuing problem of the supermarket. Specifically, the study aims to, number one, assess the current queuing system of SM Sucat Supermarket in the new normal to have a better baseline of the problem. Number two, to determine the major contributors that cause bottlenecks in the long queue. And number three, is to recommend a new or alternative design to the current queuing system to address the problem while maintaining the safety of the people against the virus. For the significance of the study, it will be of great benefit to the following. First, to the supermarket owner or owners, because the results will help their business improve their services to cope up with the new normal. Second, to the customers, because improved services will positively affect customer satisfaction and will minimize their exposure to the public. And third, to the students because it will serve as a proper basis for possible research regarding uncommon conditions, being that the students endeavor to come up with a credible and bona fide research study. Lastly, to future researchers, because it can be used for future research concerning queuing management or improving systems given an unusual circumstance, and to offer potential propositions concerning the problem being addressed. For the scope and limitation, the study will cover only the SM Supermarket Sucat branch during the General Community Quarantine or GCQ period in the National Capital Region from September 2020 to October 2020. The researchers will be observing the entrance queue and the specified cashier lane, that is either green basket, big cart, or priority lane, during weekend peak hours only. The study will be limited to one branch only and does not mirror other supermarkets such as Pure Gold, Shopwise, Robinson Supermarket, Metro Supermarket, and etc.
Let's now proceed with the methodology, wherein the researchers will execute a quantitative research method because the study requires collecting and analyzing numerical data. For the conceptual framework of the study, the researchers used the input process output model, shown in the slide, which provides the general structure and direction of the study. The input comprises the data gathering through observation and interviews, customer checklist survey, and queuing analysis. The data to gather are the actual number of customers served in an hour, the average number of customers served in an hour, the inter-arrival time of customers to fall in line both in the entrance and cashier lane, the average waiting time of customers both in the entrance and cashier lane, the average purchasing time of customers, the average service time per customer, the average number of cashiers open during peak hours, the current area and queue layouts, and the safety protocols implemented before entering the supermarket. For the process, it includes the data analysis using StatFit, ProModel simulation, statistical analysis, and analysis of alternative scenarios. Finally, the output contains the proposal/recommendations of the researchers. As I have said earlier, we have three steps for the data gathering. First is through observation and interviews. Second is by conducting customer checklist survey. And third is by queuing analysis. The first step is through direct observation and quick short interviews from both the customers and few employees. The observation, with minimum of 50 observation sets, will help to have a close-up assessment of the current system of the supermarket, starting from the arrival of the customers until the payment in the specified cashier lane. The observation time will range from a minimum of 2 hours to 5 hours. The interview, on the other hand, will determine if skeletal workforce contributes to the queuing problem, as well as to identify the new normal safety protocols implemented by the supermarket. The second step of data gathering is customer checklist survey. It will be distributed to the customers in queue to help determine the factors that cause bottlenecks in the system and other relevant information needed for the development of the proposed queuing model. The last step in data gathering is the queuing analysis. The procedure will cover the arrival process of customers, the behavior of customers in line, and how the customers are serviced. This method will allow the additional information needed in assessing the current system of the supermarket queue and determining what possible improvements can be made to reduce waiting time. For the data analysis, the researchers will use StatFit, ProModel simulation, and statistical analysis. The researchers will use StatFit to convert the gathered raw data into a probability distribution because this tool allows data to automatically fit continuous distribution, compare distribution types, and provide an absolute measure of each distribution's acceptability. Next is ProModel simulation to simulate the queues in the supermarket. By definition, ProModel is a powerful yet easy-to-use simulation tool for modeling all types of systems and processes accurately. It has the flexibility of a general purpose simulation language with the convenience of data-driven simulators. After performing simulation and developing proposed alternatives, a statistical test will be done to compare the simulated data with the actual data to determine better system designs. For the proposal slash recommendation, the researchers will propose an improved queuing model for SM Sucat supermarket that will target the major contributors that result in long queues and longer waiting times of customers. Consequently, the researchers will also propose new policy guidelines to support the implementation of the improved queuing model, including the safety protocols required in today's new normal. That's the end of our presentation. If you have any questions regarding our thesis proposal, you can contact us through our email account. Thank you so much for listening and have a great day.